We want to determine the equation of the blue square root function based upon how it's been transformed from the basic square root function graphed here in red. There's a couple of ways of doing this, but I think what might be helpful is to take a look at corresponding points on the two functions. So for example, if we consider this point here with coordinates 0, 0, and let's say this point here with coordinates 4, 2, and now we'll identify the corresponding points on the blue square root function. So for example, this point here, which would have coordinates 2, comma 3. And then if we increase the x coordinate by 4, we'd be at this point here with coordinates 6, 5. So if we analyze the corresponding coordinates, we can see, so if we analyze these two points, we can see that the points on the blue function have been shifted right 2 units. And also up 3 units. And this should be enough information for us to determine the equation of the blue function. So if we're reviewing transformations, if f of x is equal to the basic square root function, and we let g of x equal the function we're trying to determine the equation of, g of x is going to be equal to f of, because it's been shifted right 2 units, it's going to be f of the quantity x minus 2. And then because it's been shifted up 3 units, we'd also have plus 3. Which means the equation of the blue function would be g of x equals the square root of the quantity x minus 2 plus 3. Let's go ahead and verify this with our graphing calculator. So we'll go ahead and press y equals, type in our function. So second x squared, we have the quantity x minus 2, close parenthesis, plus 3. Let's go ahead and adjust our window so it looks just like this window. So we'll press window, x min will be negative 2, x max will be 10, y min will be negative 2, y max will be 8. Go ahead and press graph. And notice how the graph on the calculator does match the graph of the square root function in blue. Let's also verify that these two points are on this function. So we'll press second graph. And notice how this table is set on ask. Let's go ahead and change it to automatic. So we'll press second window for table set. We'll change this to automatic. So we'll go down to this row, highlight auto, and press enter. And now we'll go back to the table, second graph. And now we can see that the point 2, 3, as well as the point 6, 5, is on our function, which should be enough information to verify that we identified the equation of this function correctly. I hope you found this helpful.